Hey guys, welcome back to It's Charisse. Peace. I'm so excited about this video because it's my official first makeup tutorial video. If you do want to get a tutorial on this fabulous look, just make sure to keep watching. See you soon. Everybody, welcome back to It's Charisse Peace. Today I'm going to be using the See You Later palette by Violet Voss. Later on you will see also that I am using Morphe palettes as well. Social Butterfly 15S and also Happy Hour 15H. I am so excited for you guys. As you can see, these Morphe palettes, they're more neutral colors. So the Violet Voss, I really wanted more colors to pop. Okay, so we are.
For those of you who watched my previous video, you already know about this. I'm just putting this on my face as a moisturizer to sit under my makeup. Alrighty, so that has been rubbed in. I actually also wanted to show you guys that I did get these Sephora lip glosses, which is really, really good. I did try it. I like the clear one because I'm a gloss girl. Like, I just like gloss. See? Oh, I ate it. Girl. It tastes good. It does taste good. But yes. So let's get started with this look. I went ahead and did my eyebrows and my left eye already. As you can see, it took me some time, so the concealer kind of gathered together and you just fan it out with your finger. As you can see, again, I am using the Morphe palette 15S. I will be using in this palette the Meme Girl and also the Late Gram and the Add color. Also, again, I will be using the See You Later palette. And I will be using the Hasta La Vista, which I'll point out later, and the Wavy Baby as the glitter to make my eyes pop. In this palette, the Morphe 15S Social Butterfly, I will be using the Late Gram and the Add. Here you'll also see that I'm using this beautiful shade of green called Mean Girl. We're going to start by applying our neutral highlight color. You never want to leave it ashy white. I know you've probably seen that on a select few of individuals, but that's why I am here, to educate the girls. So I'm taking the Add and of course the Late Gram in that Morphe 15S palette and just going back and forth and blending them together. As you can see here, I am just making small strokes right underneath my eyebrow. If you mess this up, it is okay. Makeup is always fixable with either concealer, but as you can see later on, I will be going and back into my brow pompade and just refilling in the part that was lost. So if you mess up, do not worry, it is literally okay. And now we're going to start with the color. We're going to be using that Hasta La Vista in the See You Later palette, of course. As you see here, I am just placing it right above my crease because later on we're going to put another color right in the crease and then blend it all together. I'm slowly patting just so that it can be where I want it. It doesn't need to be perfect because, as I said, you're going to be blending it out. So just place it right above your crease. The brush that I'm using, it is an AOA brush. It's from a store called Miss A's. It's a very affordable store. If you're from the Houston area, it is in Willowbrook Mall, and they have everything is a dollar. You know, some things are more than a dollar, of course. Like the rings, it may be $2, but it's very inexpensive. You should definitely go check it out.
Here you'll see I am using a Morphe blending brush. As I said earlier, we're blending that out just so that it won't have those harsh lines, because the only harsh line you want is that cut crease for the shadow, the glittery shadow. Now that that is blended out, we're gonna start applying our Meme Girl color. And we're gonna use the same brush that we used to apply the Hasta La Vista. Now we are going to start applying that Meme Girl beautiful green. And we're putting it right underneath the color that we put before. It's still gonna be in the crease of your eye. It's just gonna be in the corner crease of your eye. And as you see here, I am just building a triangular shape with the color. And I'm just going to literally brush that color inward. And then we're going to go for this. This came from the beauty supply store, and it's a RK by Kiss Contour Artist. You can literally go to any beauty supply and get this. I use mainly this and this for my concealer, and if you want, you can use this for contouring as well. But as you see, I don't really use that, and I'll show you what I use in a minute. But I'm just going to take the lightest color here to create my cut crease. So you just want to lather that brush up. And make sure you have like a fine tipped brush, because you want to make sure that you have that line, that cut crease, really defined. And if you take a bigger brush, this is really not going to work as well. And I can show you an example like this one. It's also AOA Studios, but it's not as thin. And you want a smaller brush anyway that you can really maneuver.
Whenever doing my cut crease, I always make the line first, and I get it as perfect as I possibly can, and get it as high as I want to on my eyelid. And then after that, it's really like a coloring book. You know, you have a picture already there, and it's just a black line, and then you're literally free to color however you want to inside of the lines. And that's basically what I am doing here, as you can see.
So we are definitely making progress here. As you can see here, I am using the Wavy Baby from the See You Later palette. And I am just packing this on as much as possible just so that it could pop. And if you are not comfortable with using a thicker brush as I was using at first, you can use a brush similar to this one, and it'll get you as close to the cut crease line as possible without going over. But of course, if you are a veteran and you do makeup, you can keep on using the thicker brush.
So I'm just going to continue packing that on. I'm also blending in so we won't have any harsh lines. You always want to make sure that you're blending your shadow where it needs to be blended, especially in the corners of your eye. Now everything is coming together. Now we are going to focus on the inner eye. And we're going to go back into that See You Later palette and using the color Starfish. Ooh, this is moving kind of fast. So we are here at the liquid eyeliner Amuse. I did also get that at Miss Ace in Willowbrook Mall in Houston, Texas. For the liquid eyeliner, I know it's difficult for a lot of people, but I do want to make a tutorial one day, really going into how to apply that liquid eyeliner. So here I am just using the corner of my eye, the outer corner of my eye, to kind of use it as a tool to fan out where I want my wing to go. And then from that point, I just use it to come inward towards my eye. And then from there, you can just create your line right above your lash line. And you want to make it as thin or as thick as possible. That is totally up to you. As you see here, I want to emphasize the eyeshadow, so I am definitely making a thinner line. Also, I want to point out that if you don't have a wide lid, it is okay. But however, I know I worry about, even for me, when I'm applying that wet eyeliner, and I close my eyelid, it gets on my eyeshadow. So just a trick that I've learned is just to use a black pompade or whatever liner that you're using and just go over that line, and it'll kind of easily dry it up. Okay guys, our eyes are done. I am so happy with the way it came out. Y'all don't understand. I am really happy the way that it came out. So let's move on to the face. So for the sake of time, I went ahead and did my face off of camera. If you do want to see me do a full face look, just comment below so that I can go more in depth with you as far as contouring and eyeshadow. I will leave all the products that I've used in the description below, so don't you worry. But this face is fabulous, isn't it? I am just literally going over my face, just make sure everything is blended in together and it just setting properly. And I did use AnGLOWla from the crayon case, Super Scent. She is also a black owned business. You should check her out. She's always having sales, especially Black Friday. You cannot beat her Black Friday deals. So I am just here using my fingers, and then I am going to use a brush to fan it out, to make sure that it's all blended together. And you will see here shortly. Okay guys, this is the final look. Well, it's not really final yet. I do have to put on my lashes, and you'll see that later on. And I'm just blending this out so it won't look so harsh. But you can never have enough glow. Never. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. If you did, just make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. And if you could, just share it. This photo here is a no filter photo, and it is the final look with the eyelashes. This photo is, of course, with filter, and I just wanted you to see the difference. This next picture, of course, is the snake ring that I bought, and it was an inspiration of Garden of Eden, which is this look. So everyone, thank you again. It is Charisse Peace. Again, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe for me. It will greatly be appreciated, and I will see you guys next week. Bye.